The president's speech on Wednesday will no doubt dwell on the Big Four agenda. Top on that list is universal health care, which involves giving some medical cover to every Kenyan. But can this dream be truly realized? Our senior reporter Jacque Maribe now examines one challenge that could provide the ultimate test for the president's plan: staffing in public health facilities.
Doctors on the streets, and not in the hospital corridors where their services are desperately needed every day. Such has been chaos that continues to define Kenya's healthcare system 5 years after devolution took effect and nearly 55 years since independence. Dr. Ouma Oluga is the Secretary General of the Kenya Medical Practitioners and Dentists Union, the union that last year mounted one of the most crippling doctor strikes in Kenya's history. He says the question of staffing was key at the time and remains very much part of the diagnosis today.
So what happens is that in 2014, 2015 and 2016, there was an additional 3,000 doctors. So right now we should be about 6,900 at the counties, but you find that almost 2,000 have also left over the same period because of either frustrations of how they are being managed or to look for other opportunities.
The result is that Kenya now has a decimal ratio of one doctor for every 17,000 people, a far cry from the recommendation of the World Health Organization of one doctor for only 1,000 people. Indeed, according to the National Health Strategic and Investment Plan 2014-2018, the country needs at least 16,278 clinical officers, 13,141 medical officers, 23,574 enrolled nurses, and 11,335 registered nurses, 947 general surgeons, 585 obstetrician gynecologists, 552 ophthalmologists, 495 orthopedicians, and 506 pediatricians. With just 4,344 serving in all 47 counties, the country has a cumulative staffing gap of 34,445 doctors.
We are not able to attract and retain human resource for health in the very hard to reach places. For example, a lot of them end up in urban centers where I think it's easy for them to, and they're more comfortable and used to. There are also other reasons of opportunities to advance their careers by training, and so you find them being around the big urban centers as opposed to being in the rural areas. There's also a challenge in terms of their facilitation, the equipment, you know, their tools of trade. There are areas where since there is a gap, then it's a bit frustrating for you to have gone through school and be able to be in a place where you cannot deliver service optimally.
According to the founding chairman of the Doctors Union, KPMDU, Dr. Victor Ngani, the problems are bigger than just the tools of trade. In a working proposal to health stakeholders, he says tribalism, clanism, nepotism, and quote, countism have surpassed a merit in human resource management. Dr. Ngani says salary reductions, delays in non-remittance, or delay of important checkoffs are also commonplace, leading to the exodus of health workers from public service.
It is the building, it is the equipment, but it's the human capital. This human capital takes up to 18 months, especially at the nurse level, for subspecialty training.
The reason, as national government, we think it's important we address the issue of the HR for health gap is because we also have an alignment in terms of the skill set itself. We do not have a specialization in some areas, and that is why one of the responses we are taking right now is to bring in for a short period specialized doctors from Cuba.
What we need is the Cuban system, not the Cuban doctors. But having said that, I think also it is important for me to clarify, Kenyan doctors do not have a problem with doctors from all over the world, anywhere. In fact, Kenyan doctors work all over the world.
We're training more. That is a midterm intervention. But in between, the counties themselves have gotten, in some cases, into some arrangement where they actually share the resources within a cluster. It is a model that we want to encourage. Is a model that when we have brought in the specialized experts from Cuba, they will need to be serving not a specific facility, but a cluster of facilities and a cluster of counties.
So just where does the buck stop in as far as staffing is concerned? And did the drafters of the 2010 constitution give the wrong prescription in separating the functions of the national and county governments in health?
The workforce is being produced and in the volumes, but we are challenged in terms of how to absorb them into the health sector and actually put these resources into use.
President Kenyatta's ambitious Big Four agenda includes replacing patchwork coverage with universal health care, and that daunting task of attempting to give all families 100% cover will be key in his State of the Nation address.
We have covered Wanjiku. And I don't want to hear that she came to hospital and she found neither aspirin for her pain or a doctor to attend to her.
Jacque Maribe, Monday Special.